So today's video is going to be a real short one, kind of a follow-up to the piece I recently did about fat. I said several times in that video that grass-fed and finished beef has healthier fats, and that's just chemistry. It's just a fact. There's more omega-3 fats in grass-fed and finished beef. But the question I was left with for myself is, does it really taste better? I always buy it, but I thought, well, maybe that's just my imagination. Maybe I just want it to be better, and so I think it's better. But I decided to do a blind taste test today. So I cooked a couple of steaks, and I had my wife feed them to me blindfolded, and the results were a little surprising. Okay, so what I've got here is a couple of ribeye steaks. This one is just from the conventional grocery store. I've scribbled out their brand so as to not get in trouble. But it's just your basic ribeye steak from the grocery store. This one, also a ribeye, is from Buckner Family Farms, which is just a few short miles from here. This is a grass-fed and grass-finished 100% ribeye from a shorthorn cattle, just a few miles from here. And we're going to do these exactly the same side by side and see what we think. Okay, just visually, you really can see that, for one thing, the grass-fed, it's just a lot more compact and tight, and it's a little bit thicker. I don't know if you can see that on the camera. The marbling seems to be a bit more consistent, whereas the conventional steak is just kind of floppy. The conventional steak has these larger bits of fat in it. I don't know. Does that have anything to do with the way it was raised? I don't actually know. And I'm not going to do any kind of resting butter or anything fancy like that. I'm going to make these just about as plain as I can. So just a little bit of salt, a little bit of black pepper. And then I'm going to let them rest for about an hour in the fridge. Okay, and this is going to go in the fridge for 1 hour. Okay, it's time for the steaks to go on. My wife's cooking some potatoes on the other side. Don't those look amazing? Anyway, okay, so one steak goes here. This is the conventional steak goes here. Now, one of the claims about grass-fed is that it has a little bit lower overall fat content. That would seem to be the case here. It could be a coincidence, but there's certainly more fat on the grain-fed steak. That could be just this individual, so we won't pass judgment, but it is 58 after the hour. I'll come back and turn these in 5 minutes. Okay, it's been about 5 minutes. Let's give you a turn. First turn, come back in 5. Okay, it's a little early, but I'm gonna check them anyway because that the grain fed looks like it's cooking so quickly. I think because it's just kind of thick. I mean, it's just kind of thin. It's kind of flimsy. 151, holy crap, that's got some off. That thing cooked so quickly. It's at 132. 31, 14. It's a bit over, but that's okay. Yeah, on the medium side of medium rare, huh? Usually I like it a little cooler, but that's gonna be just fine. So we'll let those sit for a few minutes and cut them up. Okay, it's really bright out here, so I can't really quite see what I'm doing. But this one came off quite a bit earlier. That's the grain fed. It's so thin, it just cooked a lot quicker. It's been resting at least 5 minutes, so we're gonna go ahead and cut this guy up. Okay, so there are two questions here. One is, can I discern that there is a difference? And two, do I like one better than the other? My lovely assistant, also known as my wife, Trista, is gonna assist here. She's gonna feed me so I can't, you know, cheat. So go ahead and don't tell me what I'm eating, just give me a piece of food. Because of the salt, I might have to take a couple of bites. But okay, that was A. Now let's try B. The grass bed is B, and I'll tell you what I noticed. It's juicier. The grain fed, it was, I don't know what to say, it was flimsy. It was kind of stringy. It wasn't as juicy.
You can tell I'm asking.
Oh yeah, was I right, by the way?
You are correct.
Yeah, I thought it wasn't close.
It wasn't close. This one is way better.
Juicier, more flavor. And it just the meat was more consistent, and it had more integrity physically. And yeah, to me, it's not even close. So the grass-fed wins.
Mm-hmm.
All right. Okay, so that was surprising. And I wasn't surprised so much by the fact that I could tell the difference or the fact that I liked the grass-fed. The surprise was by how much. It wasn't even close. What I said in the first bite, even that was kind of telling, because we started with the grain-fed, and my first comment was, wow, I might need more than one bite, because all I was tasting was the salt and pepper. I wasn't really tasting the beef, and that worried me. I was like, wow, maybe I can't taste anything today. That would be embarrassing. But the fact is, it tasted bland, and that's why I was concerned that I wouldn't be able to tell the difference. And as my wife and I ate both steaks, we noticed that the more we ate of both, the bigger the differences got. By the time we were done, the grain fed just, it was very bland, it was stringy. There was definitely more fat in it. Whereas the grass fed, the beef just had more, like I said, integrity. And I don't mean that like morality. I mean, just, it was solid. It had structure. It stayed together. And that made it actually easier to cook and easier to handle, because it was just a good solid piece of meat. So yeah, it was not just better, but a whole lot better. And the more of both that we ate, the more we really started to notice how much better the grass-fed was. So the results are in. The grass-fed tastes a lot better. For $3 for a, you know, steak is expensive. So for $3 for a steak that's way more nutritious and it just tasted so much better, no brainer. I'll spend the $3 fed. I mean, if nothing else, there was more fat on the grain fed. So I was probably getting more actual edible food, plus getting superior nutrition, and knowing that the animal was treated better, $3 well spent. Absolutely. Yeah. Hands down, the grass fed wins.
But for now, it's time to wrap up this video. Thanks so much for watching. Hope to see you next time. Ciao.